All right, so we won the die roll, so we're going to go first. Well, we have both colors, a bunch of cheap spells. Looks great to me, so we're going to keep. I'm going to lead on this, and I'm just going to cycle. See if we can pick up a third land would be nice. No, but a 2-mana removal spell just as well. Pass the turn. Alright, there's our land. So we have options. We can play the 3-power creature. Or one of these 2s. I think I'm just going to go with the 3. See if we can sneak an extra point in. This card also cool because when it deals damage, you can untap a creature that you've exerted, which is kind of neat interaction. If my opponent plays a respectable 2-drop that's actually good, I might just roast it. Yeah, it's kind of annoying. Wish I had my Magma Spray. Maybe we'll draw Magma Spray. I think that's the best draw here. There's Spidery Grasp. So it could grasp. I think I just want to deploy more creatures, though. Because I'm guaranteeing giving my opponent a play next turn. This is more mana efficient. I'm not really getting any value. I'm just eating a dirtily card that's going to come back. So I'm just gonna keep putting creatures on the board. See where that takes us. I don't want to attack and trade with a creature that will just come back. So I'll pass. Hopefully our opponent doesn't have a 3-drop, and then we can exert 6 on tap. White creatures cost 1 less. Whenever you cast a creature spell, create a 1/1 white warrior creature token with vigilance. Alright, that's pretty good. Land would be great here. So with the land, I could roast my opponent's creature, get in for 6, and play another creature. Hooded Brawler. I want to get some value out of this because once my opponent plays a white creature, this is going to get no value whatsoever, so this is kind of a tough spot. It's, do I want to spend an inefficient turn to cast this Hooded Brawler here? It's going to be rough. This is not where I really want to be. I don't like the idea of Spidery Grasping. I want to get all 6. But this might be the only chance to get the 6 in like this, is to use the roast here. It's tough. I think I'm going to go with the Brawler, though. And just start pounding away, hopefully draw a land. See where we get. It's tough. It's not a great spot. We've got some beefy creatures here and some tricks, so if we can build up a pretty decent board, we might be able to do something. Another embalmed creature. and a token. Sad times for me. I am going to pound in with this creature here. I'll probably spidery grasp if my opponent tries to make a profitable block. So, if I exert, this creature will become a 5. I can eat it all if my opponent tries to double block. And then when my opponent doesn't block, I'll play the Minotaur. I don't think my opponent should block here, but... Alright. So let's go to combat. Attack and exert. Let's see what our opponent does. Come on, do it. Block. I dare you. Please block. Or don't block. I don't care. So, I will spidery grass. Both of them. I still have the brawler for next turn. Is this a snake? All right, let's see what our opponent has in store for us this turn. Goodness, that's annoying. All right, I am not a fan. Ooh, that's an interesting little card to pick up here. Very interesting. Alright, so I have options. My opponent wants to block with everything. My opponent could also just have... some kind of a trick. I could also put the car touch... here, exert everything in attack. What would happen then? This is tough. My opponent also has a bunch of mana, so there could be an impeccable timing. This is a tough turn. I could also just kill the tapper and play another 2-drop. I could also just attack and see what happens. I don't think that's right. I think this needs to come down this turn. Maybe this needs to come down on this. That'd make it a 6-5. My opponent can't deal 5 to it. If I do it here, an impeccable timing will kill this. But if I just kill the fan bearer, my opponent will have to block with something to impeccable timing and then take trample. And if that's the play, I could put the car touch here. It's a tough turn. I'm doing this. I've talked myself into it. I'm going to put it here. I'm going to pay for it. I'm going to fight the fan bearer. That appears to be the wrong one to have fought. But at least they will trade. Maybe I don't want to use this ability. No, I don't want to use this ability. Attack and exert. And kill the fan bearer next turn. White Monument is going to be tough. I don't know if we're going to be able to get through this. Our deck is just so many 2/2s that 2/2s and one toughness creatures. Electrify. Alright, so I don't have a ton of choice here. I need to just play this, I think. Six. Okay. I've not played against this White Monument yet, and I have a lot of respect for it now. Very good card. So what is my play going to be next turn? I guess I'm just going to suit this up and bash, and then play these two, play a removal spell. Tapper must die. Play that guy. Combat. Attack and exert. I'm just going to attack with this. Our opponent still has so many cards. Sure. This card has menace, so if our opponent wants to block it, they're going to block with something else as well. So many cards in hand, this is going to be tough, especially up against the clock. I spent a lot of time trying to figure out that early turn. I don't think it's going to matter. I don't know how I'm going to grind through all of this, but it's like, not only is it five cards, but it's also every creature is like another blocker. Yeah, great. Okay. Should have F6'd there because I'm not blocking. Oh, I would block this, I guess. All right, so I'm going to dome this and get in there. There's the black mana our opponent needed. Oh my goodness. What a disaster. I'm just gonna bash with everything. I don't really have much of a choice. Attack. I haven't been keeping a running total of how many free warriors there have been, but it's been a lot. Vigilance warrior tokens. Alright, I have two Minotaurs and a minute 29 to get it done. Just doesn't feel that safe. Oh my goodness. well. Let's take that. Probably not beating this. Probably not beating this. This monument is so out of control. Alright, I'm not going to try and time him out. I'm just going to scoop. Alright, well, we lost to that monument. I think it made 15 guys. It was brutal. I'll see you next. Alright, we won the die roll, and we're going to go first. We have both colors. We have a 2-mana removal spell. Not a lot of early action, though. On the play, I think we have to mulligan this. This hand's also bad. This is rough place to be. Alright, I'm going to go to 5. Alright, well, this is at least okay for 5. I'm going to bottom this. Put on the bottom. Opponent went to 6. That's kind of good. Alright. And that's it. We can hit our 4th land drop and these brawlers maybe bail us out on this mold 5. Just as good. Just gonna regular bash, no reason to exalt here. Or exert. Don't wanna try too hard. Alright, well, we're just gonna slam these Minotaurs and hope it's good enough. Okay. I feel like that could have waited and flashed that down. I mean, if I had... Well, I guess it doesn't matter all that much. But see, I drew the fourth land. Maybe I would attack with both and you could flash and eat the Vitalist. He or she. I don't... Could be either. With recognize. Alright, so we're attacking. Again, with this... This fellow. See if we can... Incite a block. Unlikely. These Minotaurs pound pretty hard, though. Crocodile. Let's see where the counter's gonna go. Alright. Removal spell would just be so gas here. This is a very strange attack. No blocks. Well, I did not really want another land. But... Sometimes that's what you got. So I'm going to exert both of my creatures and attack for 8. Exert. Exert. And bring the beats. A lot of beats. Oh, gotta put them on the stack. Whatever. Alright. Getting close. Okay. That's a good card. I want to sell those 4 cards. It's going to be rough. I really need a removal spell or a combat trick, or I think Spider Grass would be the best one. Okay, this is insanity. Oh, my opponent isn't dead to this because it's only 6. 5. Okay. So if I take this, I'm going to go to 9. And the swing back's not lethal. I can put my opponent to 4, and I'll have stuff. I think I'm just going to take and see what happens. A lot of stuff that we can draw to win here. I don't think that was one of the cards that made me win. But it is a card that helps me not lose. So... So I need this damage to go through. I don't want to trade. I want to exert. So I'm going to exert. I have to block two. I have to have two blockers to not die next turn, which I have. But trading this doesn't get me any closer. Yeah, I gotta hope my opponent has kind of nothing. And then I have to do some blocking. If I don't die, I have multiple lethal threats. Because if my opponent doesn't attack with everything, I don't necessarily have to block. So, because this card can also get to 3 power. My opponent only attacks with two things, I'll chump with the Vitalist on the 5 power. Just need to not die here. And there's a shot. Because there's a lot of... I have a lot of haymakers that can kind of do some work next turn. The active treason card will probably kill my opponent. The card that deals double damage and fours a creature and a player will get there. Spidery Grasp will untap the other. This creature, that'll and then I'll have two menace creatures. The long pause is probably a decent sign for me. I'm most afraid of an alpha attack with every card. Every creature attacking. That is what scares me the most. Because that's the one, if my opponent attacks with everything, I'm fairly certain I'll die. Alright, let's see what's coming. Darn. Well... this one. This is declare attackers. So I guess this one here. This one here. This takes away the... losing this, I can't play my 6-mana burn spell, but... I'm dead to any pump spell if I do it this way. Although I guess I could have put this here. Maybe that was the right play. I give myself another option. Opponent needs 3 blockers, or a blocker and a removal spell to get out of this. I have nothing. Let's see if we're dead. A cycle, interesting. Oh, that was it, right? Play this land. Oh, I could get fogged here. I can't do anything about fog. Fog is going to kill me. Attack and exert. Attack and exert. Moment of truth. Am I getting fogged? So I'm super dead to fog. All right, we won on a Moldified. That was great. All right, see you next round. All right, round three. So we won the die roll. So the objective of this league is to win seven times before you lose four times, and that's how you win. So we're on the play. This hand's great. We have two draw steps to draw a land. I think we can do it. If we draw it, this hand's very good. All right, I'll keep it. It's risky. Definitely risky, but the upside's very high because the hand is very good. That was not the two drop I was looking for. Alright, we got one more shot at it. And then things get dicey. Alright, we did it. What a master. Super good keep. Alright, we're in business now. We're going to be exertive. This card just impresses me so much. It looks like it should be bad. It actually looks like it should be pretty good. Alright. If I draw another land, I'll be able to cycle Deem Unworthy on this thing. Which I would do. Our opponent has a long pause in our upkeep. Ooh, Magma Spray. That's also kind of spicy. My biggest fear is that my opponent, what is my biggest fear? Puts another enchantment on this. I don't care if it attacks, but I do care if there's an enchantment that goes on this. So what is the play? I could just offer up the trade. I don't want to do that either. Magma Sprays is such a clean answer. I'm trying to think, how many things are there that can really go on this? I really want to be mana efficient. I really want to just do this. It's so clean. I think I'm just going to make this a 5-4 bash and play my other Hooded Brawler. My opponent has a lot of cards. I don't want to fall too far behind. And I will be able to get out of this with a Spidery Grasp if I need to. So I'm going to play Hooded Brawler. Going to exert. A big chunk of damage in here. That's it. Alright, let's see what happens. Alright, well, it doesn't look like it's getting pumped, so that's fairly good. Land. I was tapping my thing in my upkeep. Alright. And then cycling, does that do anything? I don't think so. I don't really have a much better play, so I'm just going to get this out of the way here. To exile with the embalmed creature. It's going to be a battle of who can draw lands, although I'm pretty far ahead, but the land is good. I can just bash for... Ooh, that was filthy. Alright. What does it do? Bring stuff back. I need my land now. There's my land. So I'll play Minotaur. This deck's very Minotaur. It's 5 mana, return all creature cards, power 2 or less from graveyard to hand. Yep. What do we have here? I think I just want to cycle this and kill the embalmer. Cycle. Bombers getting on my nerves. Yeah, I want to do it. That was the whole point. Let's see what we get. Mountain, play it. Got stuff going on now. Opponent has a lot of cards, though. Sure. That wrath was quite the blowout. Oh, don't leave it all up. That's bad for me. I don't like that. Not gonna lie, I'm pretty afraid of a lot of things right now. There are a lot of scary things that could happen. So what is the best line? I have 5 mana. So I can play... I think I'm going to play Peacemaker, Pathmaker, and then I'll attack. And if my opponent... I'll attack and exert. And then if my opponent has, like, impeccable timing, I can Spidery Grasp. So I'll play Pathmaker. Attack and exert, so no blocks. Gotta be careful with this. It's important to everything that's going on right now. Declare blocker step, alright? Oh my goodness, that is not good. I've got pieces, I just don't know if it's going to be enough. There's a lot of cards, a lot of mana, it's going to be tough. Eat this thing and bash with it again. That's my plan. So far, so good. So far, so good. All right, tough but fair, tough but fair. Minotaur down. Oh my goodness, so much mana! Wish I had so much mana. Okay, that's scary. Very scary. So I think I want to try and car touch this and then play Pathmaker here. Because an attack isn't lethal, so if you exert Glory Bound Initiate as it attacks, when you do. So if I steal it and exert it, does that mean my opponent can't untap with it? It'd be nice to have the exert text. There's so much that can go wrong with all this mana up. I need to play a 3-drop and a 2-drop. So I think I just need to do this. That was one of the worst things that could happen, but I don't really have a line that's like good against what's going on here. Play this guy. That's it. This card's so good. Definitely not blocking that. Would love to draw land here. Make 2-3 drop plays. Yes, please. Things are getting awkward. All right, land was a good start. So, what am I going to do here? I'm going to play. I'm gonna play this. I'm gonna pass. So we're untapping this. I'm gonna block and kill this thing. Not another thing. I probably can't beat this. So play this card. play this card. I'll take. I'm gonna run out of time. I have to take this. Why isn't this working? Oh, I ran out of time. I wasn't gonna win that. I might have won this game if I had more time, but yeah, I'm dead. Okay. Darn. Yeah, darn. Alright, I'm gonna keep this. Looks alright. Lands and spells, right? That's a decent pickup. Alright, yes. Got this magma spray up, ready to do some work. Hopefully get something. Not a 2-3. Perfect. Perfect. Couldn't draw it up better than this. This brawler down. Alright, off to a pretty decent start so far. We've drawn a couple spells, which is kind of what our hand needed. Sure. Alright, so how aggressive do I need to be here? I can just make this a 5-4 and bash and play the Minotaur. I'm worried about a magma spray here. I think I'm just gonna play the Minotaur. And then I'll exert this. I think this is a little safer. Attack and exert. Just get in for 5. Be ahead on the board. Ahead in the race. Can't really ask for more than that. This thing's gonna be very close to just being a 4-4 when it comes down. Doing a good job of curving out, sort of, and making land drops. I think this helps me. Or it gets cycled. I can't do. Oh, it got cycled. Okay. I'm also okay with that being cycled. Ooh, aggressive. Okay. I'm not blocking it, that's for sure. So I think I just want to play this and bash. No reason to kill this. I don't care about this. It doesn't rumble with any of my creatures. I'm just regular attack with the Minotaur. No reason to not to. At least I can't think of one. As long as I don't draw land next turn, I should be able to reasonably get Hellbent for the lizard. Cycle it, huh? Okay. Minotaur. Another Minotaur? Okay. I think I just have lethal. Oh, it's not lethal because this will trade with the thing. If I don't... Oh, okay. Sure. Okay. So that's a 5/4. So if I put... put this. Or I just want to play another Minotaur. I think the best play is to beef up. That doesn't make this live. I think the best play is to beef up Is it still lethal? Because you won't. This will be 5, 6, 7, 8. And then this will be 6. And this will have to be. Oh, it won't. Oh, this will trade with this, and my opponent will take one trample. So my opponent will have to block. Is that correct? Will have to block this, because this will be 5, 11. So if I'll eat this, then my opponent must block here. And I don't even have to exert this, right? Well, if I don't exert, my opponent can block here. And then we'll take 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It's only 10. So I have to exert to force the block. But then I'll have a 4/4 active. And this guy, and I can play the Minotaur next turn. This is only 10. Is it better to just bash with these two and play another Minotaur? Opponent doesn't have to block, but they would go to 1. Trades there. I'll have these two on board. It's a tough play. It doesn't win the game, and I'm afraid of the 6 mana make a zombie thing. do this. And then this is 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. This has to trade. My opponent takes 8 down to 3. And I think this is just good enough value. This got to be right. So put this here. No way this can backfire, right? All right, put this here. To go to combat. Attack and exert. Attack and exert. Attack. Then our opponent must trade with this brawler. Takes 5, 6, 7, 8. We'll take 9 and go to 2. I counted wrong, down to 1. Well, that makes life really easy. There are no free cyclers, and even if there were, Street Wraith does 2. And we got there. Alright, back on track with the win. See you next round. All right, welcome back. Round 5. We're 2-2. We got to get to 7 wins before we get to 4 losses. So we won the die roll. Pretty great. I want to go first. And we have 2 lands, a 2 drop, a mana. This hand's great. We're definitely keeping this. So play a land and pass. Red-green mirror, presumably. Picked up a cheap removal spell. I like that. I'm going to play the mana creature out. Kind of just want to draw like a couple of lands to curve out really sweet. Land for sure. I think I just want to get this Thresher into play. It's more mana efficient. I'm not going to do anything else with my mana, so I can get in for 1. I like this lizard. This lizard is definitely overperformed for me. This card always makes the deck. It's always good. Uh-oh. I think our opponent might be missing land drops and dying. A horrible, horrible death. I don't think there's a pyroclasm to punish me here, so... just keep getting it in there. Bash for four. Another Blazing Valley? Oh no. Alright, well that's kind of a pyroclasm. Yikes. Alright, got nothing. I did not anticipate double Blazing Valleys, but that is what happened. I probably should have just cycled this on my turn now that I think about it. I need creatures. I have removals. Cycle. Immediately punished, yep. Beginning of combat. Alright, that was not the greatest play. Could have killed this and bashed for two. So I think the play, I wish I could kill both, but I think the play is just to kill the Minotaur with the Electrify and bash with both my creatures. Bonus. Okay. What? I'm drawing two. I don't understand. I do not understand. I think Our opponent made a mistake. Yeah. Alright, whatever. Win's a win. Alright, welcome back. Round six. We're 3-2. We need to win four more before we lose two. We're on the draw. I'm going to keep this hand. It seems pretty good. Our opponent Mulligan, we're going to keep. We've got both colors. We've got the mana creature. We've got our sort of signature stuff. This was sort of the combo I was talking about, where you put the -1/-1 counter on the Vitalist and get to make your creature maximum big. Alright, our turn. Land would be okay. Perfect. Can't even draw it up this good. Alright. Pass. Just need to remember to play the green land. So we can cast our green 2-drops. Is that Evolving Wilds? Alright. So we hit a 3-drop. I'm going to play the Vitalist. I did notice we have beaten all of the not white decks we've played, and we've lost all the white decks. So hopefully this Evolving Wilds doesn't get a Plains. Actually, I don't mind if it gets a Plains. I'd like to get more matches in against the white deck and see if it's my bad play, their great draws, or my bad draws that's gotten this result. Probably all of them. Yeah, little bat. Bat friend. Well, I can't do anything else, so. Alright, so. Make green. Green, green, green. It's all green. Play this crocodile. Little crocodile rock. Put the -1/-1 counter on the Vitalist, like I talked about, how great this is. Because it's a 1/2. Gotta hit a button. And we'll just calmly, casually bash in for a million. Almost F6. That would have been bad. Declare attacker step. I choose you. Giant Pokemon monster. Get in there. I predict no blocks. And I'll pass the turn. This card's great. This combo is great. See what our opponent's going to do. Not bad. Not bad. Still not great, though. Getting combat. This bat is going to come in. Alright. So, see no reason not to Minotaur here. And then we'll shove with this crocodile. Rock with the croc. Boom. Doing it. These beats are real. Real great. I have all these pump spells. I have more creatures. Our opponent's going to need to do some things. Whenever you cycle or discard, it gets +1/+1. I don't think that's going to bail my opponent out necessarily. A mummy, right? Mum's the word. Alright, this is great. I'm going to shove with everything and I'm going to exalt this. And then almost no matter what happens, I'm going to spidery grasp and play the companion. I feel like this is probably blocking this turn, so it'll be out of the way. Probably because my opponent thinks that he or she will be able to kill some of these creatures in combat, and I don't think that that is going to happen. I'm going to be sad, so let's ship. I will exert this attack. Attack and exert. Yes, do it. Become large and menacing. Alright, your move. Soyav. Let's see what Soyav's up to. Okay. That order feels satisfactory to me. Okay. Spider Grasp. And we won! Alright, sweet. Back on track. No white cards for our opponent, so we fared very. Alright, welcome back. Round 7, 4-2. Need to win 3 more to max prize this league. So we gotta go win 3 before we lose 2. So 3-1. We won the die roll. Yeah, we wanna play. So we have green lands and a mana creature and a bunch of spidery grasps. What does this hand do? I don't really want a mulligan. I could get burned for sure. Gotta draw a mountain. This card's pretty good with the mana dork. It's close. It's definitely close. Yeah, I'm gonna keep it. My opponent also kept, so forest, go. Can't cast that one either. Alright, next turn, need a mountain. Everything comes together with a mountain. This hand really comes together. Brings the room together to get a mountain. As they say. Battlefield, put 3. Okay, well, I guess I can eat this with a spidery grasp if I need to. Mountain. Come on, do it. Give it to me. That is not what I wanted. What is this? Oh, that card's good. That card's real good. Is this a rare? Oh, it's a rare. Okay. Well, I'm going to get my one. Main phase. Alright, first blood. Really need a red source or a green spell that matters. Man, that card is good. Enters the battlefield, put 3 Megalon counter. Alright. Also awkward. Wish I had red mana. I could just get it. Alright, red mana, please. Oh my god, no. Alright, disaster averted. We still need red mana though, like real bad. Yeah, probably dead. I think it's going to be too little, too late. All right, what can I do? I think I just have to get this Manticore into play. This would have been so good last turn. Counter here. Dome my opponent. Working with a short leash here. So we can only take so many hits from this hexproof thing. Oh dear. It's gonna be tough. No blocks. I need a land here. I think the out. I have to play this and then spidery grasp this to block next turn. And am I just dead no matter what? This block's here, this block's here. I take 7. Take 7, block. Yeah, I'm dead no matter what. Is there a way out of this? Is there any way around this? 7. Oh, I take 7. And I can double. I have 2 blockers here. So if my opponent has a cycling card or a removal spell, I die. But otherwise, I see no foreseeable way out of this mess. Right? Let me just double check. This will block, can block here, this can block here. I have 6, so I can't even really do anything else. So, I'm gonna play this. Cast. What can I do here? What's going on? Needed a land is what I needed. See if there's any way out of this. I have to cast the grasp, and then I have 3 mana left over, so the best I can do is double damage, which does nothing. I could do double damage. Double damage. None of this is lethal. But should I just do the double damage anyway? Man, I'm playing with fire here. I do have 3 blockers. I have 3 blockers. I can attack with this, double damage. Dash with this. Is my opponent going to block? Double damage. I think I'm just going to wait it out. It's too risky. It's all risky. Maybe I should. Yeah. Nice. All right. All right, what do you got? Am I dead? Is this gonna work? Oh my lord, it worked. For now. So I can double damage. I can double damage and then dome the initiate to. Oh, I better do this fast. Yay! I can't believe I beat the giant hexproof guy. That was insane. Wow. Okay. Feels good. Feels real good. All right, welcome back. We are now 5-2. We need to win 2 more to maximum prize this thing. So, I won the die roll. I'm going to go first. Oh, I didn't see the forest. Okay, this hand's actually pretty good. All right, so we're going to keep. And I'll play a forest. And 6. All right. Still haven't lost to a non-white deck. All right, good start for us, not white. Spidery grass. Let's get our 2 drop in here. And that's it. Just a 2 drop. 2 drop's so important in this format. Interesting. Can't fight that one. I would consider spidery grasping it though. Stray pig, I love it. All right, attack. See if they block. So, my creature. All Alright. Comes into play. Create a 4/2 beast creature token. Kind of like a land here.
Perfect.
It's beast. Yeah, I want to do it. I want to do it every time. Let's see what we get. What do we get? Another land. Go to combat. Attack the pig. Funny how magic works sometimes, where it's like completely boned if you don't draw a land, and then you just draw two lands and it's great. Weird how that happens sometimes. What's this? Flying and it comes back. Right. Hooded Brawler. So I'm going to play my land. Play the land. I'm going to play the Croc. I'm going to put the -1/-1 here, and then I'm going to attack with everything, and I'm going to make this guy big. I see no reason this play isn't great. Here it goes. 1, 2, 3, 4. Right there. Yes. Attack and exert and regular attack. Let's do it. Yep. It's a big chunk. It's 7. But I have removal for days. Forest is a nice draw here. A lot of nice draws, honestly. I'm in pretty good shape. It's a big turn. If opponent doesn't come up with something here, they're in trouble. For sure in trouble. There's a lot of stuff. There's like a blue thing that makes a creature of base power 0/2 would be very good. I mean, kind of stuck with not a lot if that happens. They hit their land drop, good sign for them. We wait. We'll see what happens. That's not great. Oh dear. Alright. No blocks. Alright, so I think I'm just gonna, I don't even know what I'm gonna do. Let's wait and see what we draw before we start talking about what we're gonna do. Wrong color. Is there a pump spell? There's +2/+2, that'd be 4, that doesn't do it. I think I'm just gonna try and kill this. But with what? With what? This one gives me an extra point of damage. Not sure exactly what I'm playing around. Oh yeah, it makes a lot of sense to do this. Otherwise, my opponent could just block. If I do three to this, then I could trade both cards. And gotta make sure I click yes to use the ability. Slam with this giant monster. Got the electrify in case of a double block. Needs to be something to get this thing off the board right here. This thing doesn't get off the board. Yeah, it's gonna be a disaster. There's a plus two pump spell. I think that's about it. Because I would trade for the... So, if I shoot down the initiative, is it five? I believe this is like all kinds of lethal, so... Because it's four trample plus the two from this. So, yep. All right. One more to go. All right. Welcome back. Round nine. We have two chances to get to seven. The max wins for this thing. So, we won the die roll. That's a good start. Still undefeated against non-white decks. Oh, this feels like a trap. I'm going to mulligan. It's good, but geez, you got one shot to get a land. I'm gonna mulligan. I'm gonna be real. All right, this hand is acceptable. I'm gonna keep when I get the chance to keep. Scry. The power spell was good two rounds ago. That's for sure, but I think it's too early for this. So I'm going to put it on the bottom. I just want more creatures and removal. Maybe I could have kept it. I really want to get my fourth land on four. It stinks putting like your most powerful spell. It's the only rare in the deck. It's not even like a great rare, but it's pretty good. It's my most powerful card probably in the late game. We know we're not drawing to it, that's for sure. Game would have to go pretty darn long. Two drop deployed. Three drop would be very bueno. That means good in Spanish. They did have the land. They had it all along. Three drop. Here it comes. Nope. Just a regular old attack. I like this, the exert mechanic. It's pretty cool. It's a good, like... little mechanic going on. So the question is, I really want to shoot this. I want to get this down, though. I don't think my opponent will trade here. And if my opponent does trade here, I'm probably fine with it. I mean, trading up, trading a mediocre 2-drop for a pretty powerful rare. Clear attacker. Just want to make sure I don't skip through my second main phase. That would be a disaster. My opponent also has to be thinking I could just have, like, spidery grasp or something. Damage. Alright, second main, Minotaur. Like a shimmering grotto. Wow, okay. That sucks. For me. I wonder why my opponent did not attack here. So I think I'm going to bash and then I'm going to make a 5-4. If my opponent goes for any funny business, then I'll cycle. Could have the +2/+2. Target this guy and my opponent. Target creature can't attack this turn. Put a brick counter. Until your next turn, target creature can't attack or block. And its activated abilities can't be activated. Use this only if there are 3 or more. Okay. That kind of stinks. Now I wish I didn't make a big manticore. So let's cycle. Did have it. least they get to bash with the Manticore. Do I want to bash with the Manticore? Yeah, I think so. Trouble. Trying to play these cards out because I have the creature that becomes a 4/4. This card's pretty good. Didn't want to tap it down. It's gonna be a tough one. Drawn a lot of lands. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 to 6 spells. Alright, need action, need it now. Alright, that's not action. Yep. 8. This all comes back to a mistake I made earlier. I should have bashed with my big 5/3, 5/4 creature, and then my opponent was probably going to block, try and trade, and I could have cycled and blew it out. Instead, I lost everything. It's not very well sequenced. Yep. Down to 3. Magma Spray. Nope. Alright. We lose. One last chance at redemption. Alright, welcome back. Final round. We are 6-3. Oh, is my opponent not going to join the match? That'd be unfortunate. Alright, maybe this opponent will want to play me. Alright, cool. 6-3, final chance to go 7 and to get 7 wins. We're going to be on the draw. We finally lost to a non-white deck. I will say, I feel like this is a pretty good performance for this deck. This deck I didn't think was, like, blow your doors off outstanding. I think it was a good draft. I think we made good picks. But, I mean, we didn't have, like, a bunch of bomb rares or anything like that. All right, so our opponent mulliganed. We're on the draw. We need a red source. Very good if we get a red source in 2 draws. I'm going to keep... see where it goes. Okay, it's not what I wanted. Ooh, yuck. Alright. Alright, we need a land. Darn it. Alright. Discard. Probably not gonna have time for this. Really just needed any land in 3 draws, I mean. Oh, did I just skip my turn? Oh my goodness. Thought it was my opponent's turn. Alright, out of here, Spidery Grasp. Not ending on a strong suit. It's pretty late here. Alright. Let's see if we can get back in this. 3 cards left. No blocks. I feel like if I would have just played that land, I would have had a shot. So... let's Magma Spray. Play this creature. Yeah, we would have been in pretty good shape. It's going to be tough to just pitch a spell and still get there. Oh, Oh, Minotaur. Do I want to attack? I do want to attack. No, I don't want to attack. Because I don't want my opponent to attack me. And I don't want to make this trade, and I don't want to take damage. What happens if I bash here? I can eat one. See what's about to happen. Something's about to happen. I kind of want to exert both of these and bash. What's the worst? Can bad things happen? Bad things can happen. I think I'm just going to exert this. Attack and exert. All right, let's see if there's blocks. Clear blockers. Another land. Yikes. Ooh, that wrath was not good for me. Not good at all. I take it. that kill that thing? Please say no. It's going to be close. It's going to be close. It's going to be a photo finish here. Really wish I had a second spidery grasp. Yikes. That's a rough one. That is a rough one. Wish I had another spidery grasp. All right, need a spell here. Attack. If I attack, my opponent would presumably trade. I think this card is better. He has no good, he or she has no good attacks. Alright. Alright, it was at least a spell. I needed a spell. Not the worst spell either. See if attack isn't coming. Can't attack. Needed a spell. Need that spidery grasp I discarded to hand size, I would have won. So embarrassing. Oh no. Yeah, that kills me. Wish I drew that card. least taking this stupid thing that killed me down. Well, we didn't get there, but we should have gotten there. If I didn't click through my entire turn thinking that I was in my opponent's attack step, I think we win that game pretty easily. Yeah. So this deck was a pretty good example of sort of just like a very medium deck. We didn't open anything super bombastic. I think we were relatively in the right colors. It's possible we should have been in white, but we started in red. We tried out an interesting rare. So as you can see, the format's pretty interesting. It's very aggressive. Very aggressive. It's a lot of fun. I'm looking forward to playing it more. So we went 6-4. That's kind of like a 2-3 sort of draft deck, which is about where this deck should have been. If I would have played a little bit better, if I didn't skip that, we could have been 7-3. Also, I think it would be possible. I want to go back and watch the first round. If I would have made that big attack early, I might have been able to pull it out. I sort of underestimated how good that white artifact was that made 1/1 soldier tokens, where my opponent made like 15 soldier tokens over the course of the game and I couldn't win. But yeah, format feels pretty great. I'm looking forward to playing it at the Pro Tour. I'm looking forward to continuing to learn about this format and try out new decks and new color combinations and stuff. So as always, I check out the comments, I read them, I appreciate the feedback. I know I'm kind of slow at playing sometimes and skip through my turn and have to discard without playing a land sometimes, but I do the best I can, and I don't know. That's about it for today. So anyway, thanks for tuning in. Hope you enjoyed the videos. They were pretty fun to play. So have a good day. Cheers.